Hello, how are you doing today? My name is Otto and welcome back to the channel. This is part 2 of my Insta360 ONE X2 tutorial, and on the first part, I cover how to use this camera and how to access the menus. If you want to watch that part, I'll put a link up here and also on the description of the video. So on this video, I'm going to focus on how to use the Insta360 ONE X2 app to edit your video clips. So let's get started. To connect the camera to the smartphone, you need to have Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and location services on. So I'm back to the main menu and I'm going to choose album over here. So this is gonna take me to the video clips that I have both on the camera and already on the smartphone. So the best thing to do, or the way I prefer to do it, is I like to download the videos. So to download, you select a video clip and then here you can just pause it and you hit download. So it downloads to the smartphone. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select a clip and I'm gonna explain how to edit a video. But first, let's take a look at what this do over here. The left arrow is going to go back to the previous menu. This icon with an arrow up is to export the video, but I will get to that later. And this is for the menu. Here we can turn on or off the stabilization. I like to have it on. This one is to lock direction of the camera, and on most cases, I set this to on. If it's off, what it's going to do is that the camera is going to keep looking at the same direction where you started recording the video. For example, if I start recording like this, facing over there, and if I turn to the right side, what you're gonna see on the app is that the camera is still facing that way instead of looking at that point. Identify tracking targets is this little icon that will suggest if something can be tracked or not. I leave it on, but I don't use this, so you might actually just turn it off. Over here, you can reset all the edits that you've done to the video clip. You can add or remove from favorites. And here, you can also delete the clip. On the main screen, I can tap the screen to play or to pause the video. The left and right arrow will go to the previous or the next video that you have available. And here at the bottom, we have the video timeline, and I can just drag this to the left or the right side. Above the timeline, we're going to see a general menu where we can select a few things. The first one is the ratio. So if I press it, it's gonna change the ratio of the video. Then we have multi-view, which is basically a picture-in-picture style. So for the multi-view, you're going to select the starting point, let's say over here, and you drag the timeline until you want it to stop. You confirm here. Now you can see that on this section of the timeline, I have a picture-in-picture, so I can still work on this side. And this one over here is just gonna show myself. So we also have multiple ways to select it. So this is a split screen, and this is a front and back view. So right now I'm gonna delete it just because I'm not gonna use it anymore. To trim a video, you select the icon over here, and now you select the starting point where you want to trim the video. Let's say I don't want this part over here. So I'm gonna select here, and then I'm just gonna move or drag until the end. And all of that is what I want for my video clip. So let's say I'm gonna cut it right here. So then I just have to confirm over here, and that's it. With the speed icon, you can select the speed that you want. So you select over here. Now you have to select if you want to freeze the frame, or if you want to do a slow motion, or if you want the clip to go faster. So for this example, I am going to choose 8. And now I need to choose the section that I want this speed to be applied. So I'm just gonna drag it to the right side again. And I wanna go until here. So I select okay. And then this icon over here is to select if you want motion blur or not. Here on the app, it's gonna look the same, but when you export the clip, it's gonna show the motion blur. So I'm gonna keep it on and I'm gonna confirm. And now on the timeline, we have this red bar on the top indicating that this part has a speed change. So I want to play it just to see how it looks like. So if you want to change it or delete it, all you have to do is go back to speed. And here I have it, the red line, and I can just delete it and confirm. The stats icon is to select the GPS, and on filter, you can select the filter and just apply the intensity that you want. And here on the right side, you can select music. There's a big selection that comes from the app, and you can also select your own music. So on the timeline, there is a plus sign, and here's where we're going to set what we're looking at and how this is going to happen. If we look at the video, we can see that the camera is just looking straight. But let's say that instead of walking straight on the bridge, I want to be looking to the right side. So what we have to do here is, let's go back over here. So over here, I am going to put a pivot point by pressing the plus sign. And now on the main screen, you can see there's a yellow dot which indicates where the camera is looking at. But I want to change that, so I'm just going to drag this. And let's say that I want to look that way. You can see the little plus sign right there. And that's where I want it to be looking at. So I'm going to hit here where it says update keyframe. And now the yellow dot is over here. So if I go back to the initial point and press play, the camera is going to turn to the right side. Now imagine that I want to look to the right side just for a couple seconds. So here we are on second number two. So I'm going to wait until here. And I want to keep looking to the right side. So I'm going to add another pivot point here. But the yellow dot's still over there. So I'm okay because I wanted to be looking at the right side. But now I want to look back to the front. So what I can do here is I'm going to just move a little bit to the right side on the timeline. And I'm going to add a pivot point. Now yellow dot indicating I'm looking over here. So I'm going to move it. And I want to be looking right over there. So update keyframe. So here it's looking to the right side, but then the camera changes very quickly to the front. I actually want the camera to turn slowly to the front. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete this pivot point, the last one that we did here. And instead of placing it here, I'm going to just move it over here. So I'm gonna make a new one again. The yellow dot is over here. I'm gonna change it to here, and I'm gonna update the keyframe. So now it should have a different effect. Let's take a look. There we go. Now it's slower. To change the field of view, we are going to be using the same pivot points. So here I can select to add one. I want to be looking to this Japanese house. So I'm gonna update the keyframe. And here on frame, I'm going to select ultra wide, wide, linear, or narrow. And the effect is going to be different. So on wide, it's gonna be like this, linear, and narrow. And here we can also choose tiny planet, which is gonna look like this. Let's say we wanna go linear in here. Just update the keyframe and let's see how it looks like on the timeline. So it just makes kind of like a zooming effect. To do an object or person tracking, you need to add a pivot point. And then here we're gonna select deep track and we're gonna choose or select the subject. So let's say I want to track the house. Now we're gonna select start tracking and this is gonna do the animation or is gonna keep tracking through the timeline the subject. So I can just stop whatever I want, but I'm gonna just let it go and see if it keeps tracking it or not. Right, I think that's enough in here, so I'm gonna stop and let's see the result. Right, that's good. When we are on a pivot point all the way to the right side, we have this icon that says rotate. So we can use this to play with the roll axis. And here what you do with this is you just slide this bar and then you can just play around with this and you can roll to whatever degree you want to. So let's say I'm happy over there, and then over here I can add another one just to make it go straight again. So when you're ready to export the video, you're going to select the export icon over here, and now we're going to select reframe video. The app is going to start to make a quick export, but if you want to change the export settings, you can press over here. Now here you can choose between the quick export, which is already doing it in the background, or you can go on this icon and change to the custom settings. Here you can select the resolution, the bitrate, and the frame rate. Then when you go back, you have to click on quick export and actually choose custom. I also like selecting color plus and tap confirm. And this is going to make colors more vivid and dynamic range is going to be more balanced, but it will also add some noise to the video clip. So it's a good idea to select this to remove the noise. I really hope that I was able to cover at least the basics of how to edit videos. If you have any questions, please don't forget to ask on the comments down below. Don't forget that it's all about the practice to get better with the edits. My name is Otto, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.